Leon, thanks for the introduction. I'm excited to share with all of you today how the Soljechich Group is building a LiDAR-on-a-chip technology that will enable autonomous machines to see and sense the world. And this is critical because we are entering a new age of autonomy. By 2030, there will be an estimated 100 million self-driving vehicles and trucks driving us around and mobilizing our economy. And 20 million industrial robots will be packaging and delivering our products. And they all need a sensor called LiDAR to see the world. The way LiDAR works is by scanning a laser beam to build a 3D map of the local environment, enabling an autonomous machine to safely and efficiently navigate its surroundings. And the demand the LiDAR industry will need to meet is significant, since the industry expects a $30 billion market for LiDAR sensors in the next decade. There are real-world applications on the ground, on the road, and in the air. However, even though there has been significant investment over the past decade, through our customer interviews, we've discovered that LiDAR is still not good enough. So just like previous shifts in industry, where we have gone to the transistor that enabled computers as we know them, solid-state drives that make our computers faster and more reliable, and silicon photonics that is accelerating our data centers, the world needs a solid-state LiDAR-on-a-chip technology that can meet the demands of the future. During our conversations with customers, multiple companies have told us that although there has been a lot of progress, LiDAR is still too expensive. It's unreliable and breaks down over time, and it's not scalable to the millions of units required by the industry. And there are several startups trying to solve this problem, but they are still limited by their core technologies. They're not fully integrated, some are still bulky, they are still expensive, and have inadequate performance. There is still no proven long-term LiDAR solution. And so the Soljechich Group has been set out to address these remaining issues with our LiDAR-on-a-chip architecture. Our key innovation is an on-chip photonic lens design for optical beam steering. Here on the bottom left is a rendering of our first-generation design. Using standard photonic components, we can feed a laser into a specially engineered lens and grating to steer a laser over a desired field of view. More recently, we've improved our design to have a 160-degree horizontal field of view, which is up to 2 times larger than other approaches. And this novel architecture is not just an idea. After 3 years of work at MIT and MIT Lincoln Laboratory, we've demonstrated a proof of concept. Using the 8-inch wafer scale process at Lincoln Laboratory, we fabricated a demo that fits on a chip the size of a dime. Here on the bottom right are optical images of several components, including our switches, a lens, and a 32-port beam system. And as you can see from this next graphic, our lens can scan a laser over a wide field of view. And this enables our LiDAR-on-a-chip platform to meet the demanding industry requirements. We're fully solid state, which means it's low size, weight, and power, reliable and robust. We can be produced at high volume with low cost. Our sensors have advanced sensing capabilities that can provide both range and velocity information. Our system is immune to interference from the sun and other LiDAR, and we can meet the high performance demands on the ground, on the road, and in the air with a wide field of view, our long distance ranging, high resolution, and random access scanning so we can quickly focus on regions of interest. And especially thanks to the Deshpande Center, we're now building a tabletop LiDAR engine that can detect up to 10 meters of ranging. And we have an 18-month roadmap that gets us to 100-meter ranging and beyond with a large field of view and alpha testing of a portable setup. And we're even looking further, and finalizing our roadmap for a true minimum viable product that can meet all the industry demands. Our team is uniquely qualified to tackle this problem. Sam and I have been developing this technology over the past few years through our PhDs. And Tom Mahoney just graduated with a PhD in Core 6 and is an expert in novel laser design. And our PI, Professor Marin Sojicic, is a scientist and entrepreneur who has spun out three companies from our research lab. And so we would like to thank our collaborators and our supporters. And we'd like to thank you for taking the time to learn of how our LiDAR on a chip technology will enable autonomous machines to see the world. And we also ask you to join us during the breakout session if you want to learn more, or feel free to email me at jjlopez@mit.edu. And thanks in advance for your questions and interest.